What I was asking you was, how do you go about your work? How do you do live commentary when you are actually doing commentary and covering a match, Dean?
Well, I think for me, first of all, and I'm sure this actually probably includes everybody, the most important thing that you need to do is you need to ensure that you have your correct facts. Mm-hmm. And what I also like to do, especially with names that I haven't heard before, I like to also try and make very sure that I get the pronunciation of the names. You know, for example, the players from the subcontinent. I want to make very sure that I pronounce it exactly 100% correct. So normally what I would do is I approach somebody who I know who will be working with me from that country. For example, if it's a Zimbabwe-Bangladesh series, I'll make sure that I speak to Shamim Chowdhury or Atta Ali Khan, and I make very, very sure that I get the correct pronunciation. I'm very, very particular on that. And then, of course, when I'm live on air, obviously, one thing that I do need to do is to ensure that my that the stump microphones are nice and loud in my ears so that I can hear exactly what the players are doing. So obviously, as I've explained before, it's always very important to have those stump mics working nicely, because you can tell by the bowler who they are. Lots of times they give quite a grunt when they get to the crease and when they deliver the ball. And then, of course, certain shots as well. You know, I can always tell when it's a reverse sweep, because lots of times the bat actually hits the ground when they're playing the reverse sweep. You remember Andy Flower, especially, you know, that's how he used to play the reverse sweep, and Brendan Taylor as well. But there's so many batsmen around the world, or batters around the world, who play the reverse sweep with consummate ease. You know, 20, 25 years ago, we were astounded to see it. Now, every second batter plays the reverse sweep and the scoop shot and everything with such ease.
So beautifully explained by Dean Duplessis.